Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Steele, the High Level Queen, and today we are going to be talking about several of the workflow features. I'm going to cover a different feature every day, so if the feature that you want is not in this video, make sure to check out my other workflow videos. Let's get started. All right, so just really quickly, in case you don't know, workflows are the new way to send campaigns and triggers inside HighLevel. If you haven't heard of HighLevel, you can get a free 14-day trial using my link below. Okay, so what we're gonna do here is at the top, you can see that it says add new workflow trigger. Now, this was what was previously on the left-hand side of the trigger window. Now you can see here that I can choose between HighLevel and Facebook. I'm just going to keep it on HighLevel right now, and that I can run triggers on anything from appointments to D&D, contact tag, customer replied, email events, form submitted, survey submitted, etc. Okay, so let's just say that I want to run it on when a contact tag is added, and then I can add a contact tag. Okay. Then what I'm going to do here is add an action. Now, these are what I want to go over with you today. Today, we're going to be talking about opportunity cards and why you should use them in workflows. Okay. So I have a workflow open here, and we are going to go ahead and add an action. Now, you have a couple options when it comes to opportunities. And what an opportunity is, basically, if you use pipelines in HighLevel, which I highly recommend that you do, and I actually have another video on how to set up your pipeline, you can add or remove people from pipelines based on their behavior inside of your workflow. So let's say that in this workflow, I have someone giving a negative intent, and if that person gives a negative intent, what we can do is we can remove the opportunity card, okay? So this is just an example. And then if they have a positive intent, then we can add an opportunity. So here, we can say the full name here on the source. You can actually go into the attribution and you can choose the different source. And then on the lead value, you can either make this a custom value or you can type it in. And then you can update the status accordingly if you want. Also, allow opportunity to move to any previous stage. So this makes it enable to move back. And then allow duplicate opportunities. This is going to start duplicating them. I don't personally use this because I think it's super confusing. Okay. So those are the different opportunity options for workflows. And again, don't forget to check out the rest of my workflow videos if you didn't find what you were looking for. If you need a free 14-day trial, use the link below to get my bonuses. And don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos from me. And I'll see you next time.